A big hello and warm welcome to all of you who are listening to me once again. Can't thank you enough, guys, for this. Well, today I wanted to speak about spirituality, and I had been consolidating material for that. But when I started going through it as a third person, I encountered many unanswerable questions and vague terms. To begin with, the discourse started by saying spirituality does not have a conclusive definition. And in all probability, it will start with that line when I do complete that discourse sometime later. Secondly, spirituality has nothing unique in itself. It spans across multiple domains today, ranging from religious practices to self-empowerment, mind control, to abundance and transcendence and whatnot, with very little or no overlap at all. Third, it is so very subjective, as in everyone will not have the same experiences, or some may have no experiences at all. Going further, multiple times spirituality will speak of a term called the other dimension or something called a sixth sense. Well, I have had some fleeting glimpses of these things, but I'm not sure what it was. I certainly can't define it in words. If you're interested, you can refer to a chapter titled Bliss in this very series on my channel to know what I have experienced. Those experiences could have been my vague imaginations or my mind playing games with me or plain simple hallucinations. Well, I can staunchly say that they were spiritual movements, but I can't prove it in any way. So, point is, I could not complete my discourse on spirituality. But what it brought to mind was talking about why I can't speak about spirituality. The spiritual realm always keeps referring to something beyond the five senses, beyond the reach of science, beyond the boundaries of time and other such things. And the worst part of it is, we believe in it without asking for proof. That's ridiculous. If our qualified regular family physician prescribes us a pill, we go home and Google for it to see if it's correct for us, don't we? That's the kind of trust we have in our own education system. But if some saintly, priestly, sagely looking person comes and smears us with all the vagaries of the other dimension, we will accept it without any question. Why? There's actually a real-time filmed short film on this. A young American dresses up like a preacher and goes about saying nice things to people. Eventually, people start following him everywhere. He becomes a master of sorts. All the while, he is being shot on camera and all he is doing is acting in a film. In the end, he just discloses his identity, saying he is just a young American, nothing else. I don't remember the name of the film, maybe somebody of you might know about it. I'll share it with you as I remember. There are these five basic senses that we all generally are gifted with: sight, sound, smell, taste and touch. Aren't these the very senses which have kept us alive till now? If not for them, we would have died as kids. Run over by a car or falling off a roof or burnt in a fire. No, these are the very five senses that have enabled us to experience so much of pleasure, so much of delight, so much of joy till now, isn't it? These are the five senses which have enabled us to acquire so much of knowledge. I dare say we are intelligent because we have knowledge. After all, by basic definition, intelligence is the ability to learn and apply knowledge. In the first place, if you had no knowledge, you could not possibly be intelligent. And you see, no one is born with intelligence. By all our common standards of intelligence, all small kids are stupid, right? If you look at it practically, of course you have a warm heart and you have emotions and all that. But by the standards of intelligence, small kids are stupid. They do stupid things. Kids, they develop intelligence as they grow, by acquiring knowledge, by being curious to know more. and then by applying generalization. That's what we are also doing, right? By using these five senses, we have built strong houses for ourselves. We sleep on cozy beds in an air-conditioned environment, browse the internet, use Facebook for social connects, use YouTube for talking to other people, etc., etc. How can we turn a blind eye to all of this and start running behind a sixth sense? How can we denounce the sciences that gave us so much till this day in search of some, you know, unknown, undefined, divine philosophy? Personally, I am not an atheist. I have not shed off my religion. I am spiritual. Repeat, I am spiritual. We all are spirits. We have something inside us known as life. So we all are spiritual by nature. No one needs to teach us spirituality. Thinking is all that is required. Shut yourselves in some remote corner for a week and do nothing. Speak to no one, no TV, no internet, no mobiles, no thinking, no chanting, praying, nothing. Just shut yourself down. Switch off. You will be a different person on the eighth day with completely new targets for your future. Have you ever tried this? In India, we call it Vipassana. There are special centers for this. For 8 days, you are not allowed to speak to each other and you are given very simple, basic, healthy food to eat. That's all that happens in the center. Most people find it impossible to sustain beyond 2 or 3 days. And those who do sustain, they come back completely changed. No teachers, no preachers, no sermons, no mantras, sutras, nothing. Spirituality in itself is not a problem. It is not a problem. Neither is religion. They are aimed at betterment of human lives. It's the teachers and the preachers who are a problem. They will harp upon things which are convenient and profitable for them. See, they do not have the muscle to rob you. So they willingly make you pay and also make you feel obliged for it. How? From day one, they will tell you your five senses are imperfect. They are not sufficient. This is what they will start with. That's the baseline. They'll keep telling you that there are things beyond your intellect. Of course, there are things beyond my intellect. I'm sure there are. There are things that I don't know. And I'm not ashamed of it at all. I can't know everything, can I? But then, neither can the teacher or the preacher know everything, right? If all the sharpest brains in the world's scientific community put together are not able to tell you something, how can someone who has just returned after years from a forest or a mountain or an island know it? It's impossible. Well, if I don't know something, it's just that. I don't know. No need to link it to a superpower, some mystic illusions. The unknown will become known tomorrow, and our next generations will laugh at how stupid we were to believe in all this divine spirituality stuff. All this time, this has been happening. You know, this has happened. We laugh at some things our ancestors believed in, don't we? We do. Now, unless you are enrolled for a spirituality class or you have kind of been beaten with spirituality right from your birth, you will agree with me. This is what it is. Like I said, I am not an atheist. I haven't given up my religion. I am fully spiritual. But above all that, I am rational. I respect reason. So, let me know what you think about this. I strayed a bit, I know, but it happens that way when one doesn't have a script or specified subject to speak upon. So, goodbye for now and hope to see you again. Please do subscribe to my channel immediately if you have liked this discourse. I am no longer sure that my posts will get approved in all the groups. going ahead. I have had 9 disapproved posts from different groups to my credit in the last 14 days. And the reason is unspecified. If you are listening to this, this group is not one of those who rejected. But anyway, point is, do subscribe immediately. You are going to forget it after 5 minutes. I would like to have all you intelligent, reasonable, rational guys around me when I speak of something the next time. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.